Yep,
hey,
good.
What's going on, YouTube? Let my brother videotape this. I'm sure you saw the video I did earlier. It's kind of hard to tell, but I was playing with this puddle here. She didn't like it, and I'm going to keep messing with it. Like I said, it's a process. You got to keep on doing it until they're used to it. The first time, she's kind of walking around dancing. It's kind of hard to tell. I'm sure on the video, because the way I had my little tripod, she jumped it, and I came back, and I got her back in there. So I'm going to see how she does now, and I don't know if she's going to jump it or she's going to dance around it. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll go to it and go back. Sometimes I'll try my best to go towards it, straight on. If she don't like that, I'll go at an angle. Just, you know, I'm constantly feeling how she acts. I'll try to get her to the side of it. So she's still stepping in a little bit. There's water over here, but I want it in this main puddle here. You know, I will let them stand here and think about it some, but you know, I ain't gonna stand here forever. You know, I am going to get her in this puddle. It's not gonna take hours on end. I mean, it's ridiculous. So sometimes I'll walk and then try to turn them into it. I need a little bit of pressure, feet. She's not sure of it, obviously. About it, you know, each horse is different. Some horses will jump all the time, some horses will buck, some horses will just run backwards. I'm just not sure of it. We've got to keep on doing it. Walk right up to it, then she pauses. Like I said, this right here isn't for everybody. If you don't want to do it on your back, you're not too sure of yourself riding, then don't. You can work on it on the ground. But if you have a decent horse and you actually think you can ride, there's no reason why you can't do this on the back. I'm not going to get off because she's not getting in here and lead her in here. It's not going to happen. She stepped in here a few times. Got in it. Not sure of it. Didn't like the splash, and that's okay. Walk off and do it again. You know, like I said, it's not, you know, kind of boring watching sometimes. But I want her to know this water ain't gonna hurt her. Sometimes to get her to move forward, I'll turn her. I'll turn her neck some so she has to take a step. She's gonna zigzag around sometimes. We know what she's in.
Back up. Come on. There you go. Good boy.
She's been playing it all for one. That's good. Let her find out that this putter's not going to hurt. She's very aggravated. She's going to have to get over herself. Made her do something that she don't want to do. And I'm making her stand in it. That's okay. She can pause. hollering and all she wants. But we got in there, she splashed around in it. She found out real quick it didn't hurt her none. You know, she can take a step or two, I'm fine with that. But, you know, and it's going to take time. You know, I got her in there. I try my best. I always make sure they go by whatever they spook at, make sure they're not scared of it anymore. When it deals with water and stuff, it might take a little bit more time. I got her in it, but obviously you can see she's still dancing around it. It'll take a time or two for me to get her completely used to it. But obviously you see the process. I'm not out here beating her. I don't have spurs on. And we got her in there. She started dancing around in it. Then she started pawing it. And I'm okay with that. So it was a little process of getting her in the water. And thanks for watching.